This is literally me before every single video. Namaste guys, it's me, Listomaniac10. If you don't know me, I'm Tanishka. And I'm hoping you have subscribed to my channel below. So without any further ado, let's get on with the video. Sorry. Now, before starting the video, I really want to apologize to all of y'all that I am being really inactive and not uploading videos. I'm really, really, really sorry. And there are some problems occurring which I cannot explain to y'all now. But yes, I promise to all of you that I'm going to be uploading soon as possible when this lockdown is over and the problem is also over. So cut to the chase, let's get on with the video. As I've read by the title, today's video is going to be relationship advice. Now you might be wondering, what is relationship advice? I'm going to be calling bunch of my friends and asking them questions based on relationship and their opinions, thoughts on that question related to relationship. The friends that are going to be included in this video are Aryesh, Amos, Shushmita and Nishtha. So I'm going to see what are their opinions in this video and I'm going to ask them 6 questions each. So let's see what they say.
Hello.
Hello, Shushmita.
Hi.
What's up?
Nothing much. I was just chilling.
Okay.
Hello.
Hello, Amos. What's
Hello.
Up?
Nothing much, just bored.
Mm-hmm.
Quarantine.
मजे आ रहे हैं कि मतलब बोर
बोर
हाँ वो तो है बट
हेलो
आरेश हाँ What's up?
Nothing much.
Hello, Nishtha.
Hi, Tanishka.
What's up?
I'm good, you say?
So, as you know, I'm going to be asking you a few questions about relationship and your opinions about it.
Mm-hmm.
And there are going to be in total 6 questions. So, are you ready?
There are going to be how many questions?
6 questions.
Okay, 6 questions.
So,
okay.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, about relationship?
Everything.
Except for the questions I've told him.
Yeah,
okay.
I'm completing. Wait for it.
Okay, about relationship and your opinions.
Okay.
So there are in total 6 questions I'm going to be asking you. So you're ready? पूछने वाले हो रिलेशनशिप के रिलेटिंग सो स्टार्टिंग विद द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन द जूसी वन व्हाट्स योर रिलेशनशिप स्टेटस सिंगल और कमिटेड समवन स्पेशल ओके फर्स्ट जूसी क्वेश्चन इज Shut up.
Why are you having that KBC vibe? Are you having a French beard and are you 6 feet tall?
No. Can we move towards the question?
You
okay? Are you single or committed?
I'm committed. As of the 11th May 2020.
Oh.
Damn. I'm committed forever, like.
Are you single or committed?
I'm committed.
Okay.
Yep.
Someone special?
Someone special on committed. I'm special. Obviously, girlfriend. Yeah, come on.
पता है मैं मजाक कर रही हूँ. Are you single or committed?
Single.
Single. Are you ready to mingle?
No. Not right now, at least.
Okay. Okay. Really? Not right now.
Not right now.
Okay. okay. Moving towards the second question, how long should you be knowing a person before dating them?
In my opinion, time doesn't matter. Like, you know, you can know a person for 9 years, you can, you know, be totally crushing on them, but still that person may be not worth it. But the person you know, like, since 2 months or something, that person can do stuff that no one else did for you. So I guess time doesn't matter. All that matters is the person's character and the person's way of living, the person's manner.
That is true. Yes, that is true, that time does not matter, but everybody's opinion are like not the same, so
it really doesn't depend. If they love each other, there's no need to know about each other, you know. They can just, you know, hang out for a date, and date is not like a relationship. Many dates may have to, it's like a date for, you know, meeting each other, knowing each other. It's just like for that.
Good answer. The next question is, how old do you think a person should come into a relationship?
The age.
How old, right?
Yeah, like the age matter. Which age?
Yeah,
what age do you think?
Any age is possible, first of all.
Okay.
Like, there are people I have seen when I was in 10th, I have seen like children of first standard, like the boy, you know, kisses the girl on the cheek, and I don't know, that's like, they're not mature enough to know that this is a relationship. Because at that moment, at that age, the relationship is telling me something. So, you know, paisa. So, but I would say the best age for a person, irrespective of any, like, if he's good or bad or whatever, for a general person, it would be 14, I guess.
Okay, so according to you.
अपना थोड़ा थोड़ा mind develop होने लगता है. थोड़ा
क्लियर होने लगता है. सबकी ओपिनियंस अलग होती है ना, तो इसके लिए.
या बट 14 इज लाइक द बेस्ट एज आई वुड से टू अंडरस्टैंड वन सेल्फ, बिकॉज़ एज अ वाइज पर्सन वन सेड, इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड योरसेल्फ देन ओनली यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द अदर पर्सन.
ओहो,
या
लाइंस. ओके,
पर्सन इज मी बाय द वे, सो इट्स कोड दैट इन डबल कोलन.
ओहो,
quotation mark
for all. Whatever.
I think love is defined according to age.
Okay. So like you think that at any age, तुम किसी भी age में like date कर सकते हो.
हाँ, जब तुम realize करते हो कि तुम actually किसी को पसंद करते हो, तो
okay. Okay. Now moving towards the question. Is if a guy reads your message, like now's word, like if a guy reads your message and keeps you on send, seen. So is it okay, good or bad?
Not at all okay. Not at all okay. Like, how, dude, I am sending you something in a message, you should reply. I am not talking to the walls or talking to the app of Instagram or WhatsApp or any platform. I am talking to you specifically, you. And if I remove my time and talk to you, that means you should have some courtesy in you to talk to me. But if you keep my message unseen, I will keep you seen in my life. I won't even text you again.
But sometimes it can be that they are stuck in some work or something, you know, like
okay, stuck in some work, text me, I am busy, I'll talk to you later.
Yeah,
I
that
don't
is
think it. That texting would take literally 4 seconds of their life, 2 to 4 seconds. If they can't even spend 2 to 4 seconds, I don't know what work they are doing. Are they, you know, digging some ground to bury someone in that? No one knows.
Yup.
See, I can't tell you with advice, but it depends on the situation of her. It
okay.
can be her parents sitting beside her, so she just seized on it and she left it. Or maybe it's a fight between us both, or she ignored it. So it can be a bad way in a good way also. So it really doesn't matter.
Great. The is. What's the best place for the first date, according to you?
Best place for the first date, okay?
Yep.
Best
place for the first date. I would say best place would be a restaurant or a cafe.
And why so?
Why so? Because there are like, there are tables, okay? There are like 2 per table and all. And there we can have the most intimate conversations without anyone hearing.
Okay.
Like, if now we close, we have to like, suppose now we go to any cafe, like a Starbucks. So,
okay.
We can sit on one table, we can talk to each other in like a low tone, you know. We can talk about life, we can talk about what we have to do ahead, we can talk about many things. And no one's going to snoop in or anything because we can see everywhere, right? So.
Yeah.
One will be like sneaking into the conversation.
Okay. So, like, cut to the chase. That restaurant and any like good place
okay,
as such.
Okay, yeah.
Now.
Maybe in some cute restaurant.
Okay. So this is your answer for this?
Yeah.
Okay. Now moving towards the question. Who should say I like you first? The guy or a girl?
Who should say I like you first?
Yeah.
In my opinion would be the most stereotypical. I would say the guy.
Mm-hmm.
If I had 2 choices.
Every girl like wants a guy to make the first move.
Yeah.
To be a gentleman.
Yeah, it's like, you know, the stereotypical movies and stuff, they are like, the guy will go and like, you know, with a rose in his hand, with, you know, bouquets, teddies, chocolates, etc. But my opinion...
Stop it. Get some help.
My opinion is a bit stereotypical, but I guess in today's life, I don't think it matters. You know, even a girl can go and do it.
Mm-hmm.
But
yes, like girls, they love
make the first move.
Yeah.
In my case, everything I only took the first move. I'm literally like.
I would say if it's fucking like both the anime at the same time, that's like the best feeling ever. But that is also like, you know, a theoretical assumption. But I would say like as in my case, okay, in my case mein, I loved my girl like way back, like before she used to, like she used to not like me then, but I used to always have a crush on her, and then suddenly we became best friends, and you know, one night I was just talking to her and she was like, so when are you proposing me, and she just cut the call.
Okay.
And next day I proposed to her, so on paper I said I love you first, but she was the one who, you know, triggered it.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say,
according to you, do you think the guy should say first or the girl?
No. Any gender does not matter. Like, anyone can say I love you first. As long as it's mutual, it's totally okay.
Yep. Okay.
See, it depends on the nature of a boy. If he's shy, then the girl should approach him first.
Okay.
And if the girl is shy, the boy should approach first. It goes like that.
ऐसा कोई स्पेसिफिक नहीं है, जिसको पहले बोलना है वो बोल सकता है.
ऐसा क्या?
हाँ.
ओके, बट अगर ओके, योर ओपिनियन इज दैट. सो मूविंग टुवर्ड्स द लास्ट 2 questions, सम जूसी questions अगेन. सो डू यू थिंक फ्लर्टिंग काउंट्स एज चीटिंग इन अ रिलेशनशिप?
You are in a relationship and you are flirting with someone else.
Yeah, like healthy flirting or any kind of a flirting.
Yeah, I won't say it is 100% cheating, but at some point it is, because you know, you if you are with some girl, you shouldn't, you know, go and, you know, be the same way to another girl. You shouldn't make another girl feel special as you make your girl feel special. I don't like it, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yeah, like if you have like Telepal's chocolate, why would you want another thing?
Oh, kya example hai. Baba. Yeah, that is true. Ki, of course, like, okay, like, not on purpose flirting sometimes, it's okay, but then.
Not on purpose. they won't be like, oh, I was intoxicated, that's why I hated that. No.
Mm-hmm.
If you're saying something, it means that you are in your full hosho awaz.
Oh.
A new Hindi word. I'm not a Hindi student, but still, a Hindi word.
I am.
And I'm happy. That's quite an achievement for me.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it does.
It does?
Knowingly, it actually does. And certainly is not a thing you can't do unknowingly. You can do unknowingly. Like, you can't just be like, oh, well, this is your thing. Certainly is something that you, ek insan kar deta hai janbujh ke. And mm-hmm. that does count as cheating. And that wo janbujh ke nikalta bhi isliye hai ki kahin na kahin that person ka feelings towards his partner, his or her partner, are not that strong.
Mm-hmm.
So, it can go flirt, nikal jata. But if you look at some relationships, so they are like, understanding and knowledge so strong ki they are for the boy is for the girl and the girl is for the boy. So,
okay. Understood.
Flirt is counter cheating.
Flirting, yeah. It depends. See, flirting must be kiya ja sakta. It can be by purposely also.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's up to the girl and the boy, whoever flirts.
Mm-hmm.
So, thodi insecurity to hoti hai agar samajh ke beech mein. So, obviously.
Yeah. According to me, it is a cheating.
Okay. And why so, if I can ask?
Yeah, sure. Because the partner may not like it. It would be like hurtful to maybe like him or her.
Okay.
Not everybody likes flirting and everything, right?
Yeah, means like flirting with another person.
Flirting with another person is
the
wrong thing.
Yeah. Oh. Last and final question. Give us one tip of yours which a person should do in a relationship and should not do in a relationship.
Give one what?
Tip of yours, Sushmita's tip, that a person should do in a relationship and a person should not do in a relationship.
Should do in a relationship, I have tons of things. Okay, out of them, one I would say should do is always, you know, show your love and affection for your better half. Always be present for them. Always be by their side. Always, you know.
From one thing, it is becoming like million.
Ab wo carry kar raha na, ek cheez bol ke char dena aa raha. Seriously, not like that. But I'm saying ke show love and affection to your partner. That's more than enough.
Yep. And what
you shouldn't do is break their trust by any means. And that doesn't only count in cheating. That means in any way. For example, they told you something not to do and still you do that stuff. Then that is again breaking of trust.
Yep.
So once if your you know that your partner has said something that you shouldn't do, then don't do it. And if it is for your betterment, if it is no and you have a reasonable point to, you know, justify your actions, then it's okay.
Yep.
Then that comes down to mutual understanding.
Yes.
Okay, one Amos tip, right?
Yep.
Amos tip that you should do. One thing you should do is keep the surprises alive.
Mm-hmm.
Like, even if you're with a girl for like 7 years, 8 years, keep those surprises alive. Don't be like, arey, tere ko to pata hai ye sab. Because a surprise is like that part of a relationship is what, like, it's like matti mein pani kaise, it keeps it wet, so it keeps it fresh. So a surprise does that to a relationship, it keeps it fresh. It brings the joy and the happiness. And one thing you should not do in a relationship is, I would say, as for me, would be to underestimate your opposite person.
Okay.
Like, sometimes the boy and the girl may have an understanding ki main to mazak uda raha hu, but most times it's like if you are like ki main ye to kar nahi sakti.
Mm-hmm.
So that's like underestimating, and for any boy / girl, anyone, any insan ke liye, it's a very, they don't feel good, right? Nobody feels good when you underestimate.
Mm-hmm.
Especially when जब इतना trust किया है किसी में and वो underestimate करता है तो बहुत धोखा दे सकता है.
Yep.
So I would say don't underestimate her.
Okay.
If you're joking, if you're funny, if you're keeping the humor alive, it's all okay. But don't really underestimate anyone.
Okay.
Including especially your girlfriend or your boyfriend.
Okay, firstly, if you're staying in a relationship, respect the girl or the boy.
Okay.
The first thing, get to know about her or him. Hmm. Whenever he is pissed or she is pissed, try to calm her down instead of fighting.
Okay.
And just handle the situation and stay in the wrong relationship. And so, love each other.
So this is should do or shouldn't do?
This should do.
Okay. And shouldn't do?
Shouldn't do is that if a girl or a boy is pissed, like if your boyfriend or girlfriend is pissed, try to calm her down instead of fighting. You shouldn't fight with her. If she's pissed, like, you can't say anything like that at all, you shouldn't fight with him or her.
Okay.
That you shouldn't do.
Mm-hmm.
If a boy and a girl truly love you, never cheat her by flirting with another girl or a boy, or like getting close to another boy or a girl.
Okay.
The person should do is like he should be loyal or she should be loyal.
Okay.
And they shouldn't just cheat, like double dating and things like that.
Okay.
So
that's a tip. So here we finish off with all the questions and thank you for joining on my video. Yes, and thank you for joining in my video.
9 minutes, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Really hard on a schedule.
Thank you, Arish, for being a part of my video.
Thank you so much, Tandish, for making me part of your video.
So thank you so much, Nista, for joining on my video.
And you're welcome. It's
a great
pleasure.
So, bye! Thanks guys for watching. I hope you have enjoyed the video. And don't forget to
like,
share,
comment to our channel,
and subscribe to Listomaniac Time.
Also, do not forget to follow my friend's Instagram handle and YouTube channel. Links will be down in the descriptions. And love you guys. Bye.